Well, we are super excited because viewers love a show set behind bars. Prisoner, Wentworth, Prison Break, and of course, Orange is the New Black. Well, some of the stars of the Netflix in Australia are here in our beautiful country to participate in the Sydney Gay and Lesbian Mardi Gras this weekend and offer their support. And we are thrilled to have them in the studio. A bit excited. Please welcome Danielle Brooks, Samira Wiley, Yael Stone, and Lea DeLaria to Studio 10. Yael, if I can start with you, welcome back to our beautiful country.
Oh, thank you so much. It's lovely to be here.
How does it feel to be part of such an extraordinarily successful show and to come back to your home country and show off?
I feel lucky as hell, and I have felt like that for the 6 years that we've been making this show. It's been unbelievable from the beginning. It continues to surprise and overwhelm me, not only creatively in terms of the stories we get to tell and share, but the friendships that we have made over the years. People say this, but we're a family. It's a little cheesy, but it's absolutely the truth, and that's been one of the most beautiful things that have come from this.
You can tell you're a family.
Yeah. And it must be really exciting that you're bringing your family to Australia. Yes, I got to take these guys to my house, actually, the other day, and it was so surreal just having worlds collide like that, and it felt so right and so nice. Yeah.
So Danielle, has Yael told you about the Mardi Gras? Do you know what to expect?
No, she hasn't. We haven't had a one-on-one about the Mardi Gras.
I didn't prep them. I just felt like, just send them in.
But it seems widely celebrated here, and we're super excited about tomorrow.
So cool.
There's a Netflix float. Please come and check us out, whoever's watching, to see us on the float. So we're really excited to be here and celebrate with you guys.
Oh, it's such a great night. You're going to have so much fun.
And what? Cher's performing, I think, right?
Yes, she is. Yeah. Cher is performing, which is incredible. It's the 40th anniversary of Gay Mardi Gras, which is incredible. What we all love about the show, I think, is the fact that it's such strong female characters. Do you think this is a really important time in history to be part of, especially with Me Too?
Are you throwing that to me?
Yeah.
Oh. throw it to the lesbian. Yeah, I think it's an incredibly important time. I think our show had a lot to do with what's going on. I think that it put us out there as women. I mean, how often do you turn on the television and see yourself as a female? Mm-hmm. How often do you see a group of women not talking about whether or not their ass looks fat in their jeans? You know what I mean? The important, real female things. And I think a conversation started that changed our industry, the entertainment industry, and it has just bled out onto everything, which has now given us the Time's Up movement and the Me Too movement. And I think right now it is the future. Is female and and it started right here. Yeah, absolutely.
Now, Yael, I'm having my fangirl moment because I have followed you for a really long time through all your theatre days. So I've seen you play some amazing roles. I saw you shave your head for something. So you play these extreme characters. Talking about your accent that you have on Orange is the New Black, Boston / Brooklyn.
Lord, no. Bring it into the room.
Yeah,
bring it into the room.
Yeah, Lea just said, she was like, I think you should do the accent. Just pretend you're not Australian. And I was going to be like, oh, what a fabulous country you've got here. What are these, koalas? Oh, I love it. The weather is wonderful.
So who are you channeling? It's sounding a bit Cyndi Lauper.
Who knows who I'm channeling? I mean, I'm really a long-term fan of Fran Drescher. I must admit that.
Yeah.
But, yeah, no, who knows? It's coming from deep inside. I'm not
from very deep. Your baby might come out talking with a Boston accent.
I'm open to all accents, whatever you want, little one.
Samira, there's been so much speculation about the new series. I know you can't give away a lot of detail. Can you give us any sneak peeks or any details about what might be coming up?
On which series?
Orange is the New Black. Oh,
I can't.
Oh! That's disappointing.
You're the perfect person to pass.
I love that. I love that it was passed to you.
I literally have no idea.
Yeah. Samira's character was much loved and much missed, but she is unable to provide any details on that at this point.
Yeah,
but Samira, you're also on The Handmaid's Tale,
yes.
Which is another huge controversial
amazing series about women. Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. So what's going on in season two for that? Can you, tell us that?
I've really been lucky in my career to, in both the shows that I've been involved in, have had, you know, so many women in power, in positions of power. And I feel so lucky, you know, that my career has followed that path. But in terms of what happens in Handmaid's Tale season two, I'm in it. Still.
Newsflash. I found it very confronting to watch that because it's very, especially with what's been going on recently, mm-hmm. it's actually not that extreme, is it really, to what can actually happen in our world, mm-hmm. and don't you think?
Yeah, and I think that that is what makes it so relevant and so scary in a way. Mm-hmm. But I think that in a way that the series is about hope. And is about getting past that and what drives us. Mm. And I think that's what I want people to hold on to.
Nice. Because it is an important part in history because you even think this can't happen in the yeah. And then you think, my gosh, with what's been going on, it yeah. is quite possible. And can you say that it we can look forward to season two, something good's going to happen? Because it ended cliffhanger at the end of season one.
Season two, I'm just going to be honest, is probably going to be more bleak.
Best to slow you stand.
Yeah, right.
Like, is it true? I was reading somewhere that you were once arrested because you were saying for being gay. Is there something going
on? No, I was arrested twice, actually, both in Missouri and Illinois. When I came out, I'm much older than I look. I'm 135 years old.
And your skincare regime, because it's extraordinary.
Well, she really does have the peels. Yeah.
No. It's all genes in my part, because they can tell you it is not from me taking care of myself. Yeah. But I turned 60 in May. So when I came out, it was illegal to be queer in every state of the United States. So in both Illinois and Missouri, I was arrested for open and notorious homosexuality. That was the law that I broke. I was holding a girl's hand in Illinois. In Missouri, I was doing a lot more. It was notorious.
Even though the celebration, as I mentioned earlier, 40th anniversary of the gay and lesbian Mardi Gras, and when it first happened in 1978, it was actually a protest march. Can you believe we've come so far?
I have to applaud your program because by watching your program, I understand the history of the gay movement here in Australia. You talked about the 78ers mm-hmm. and how they have afloat, and it's all the people that were there for the original riot. Mm-hmm. So this, we're talking about a riot that happened 10 years after the one that happened for us in mm-hmm. New York, right? And that it started out as a peaceful protest, and the cops came in and busted it up. This is like Reader's Digest version for you guys. Cops came in and busted it up. They had permits. They still stopped them. A lot of people were arrested. I saw tons of footage on it. I think what I want to say is that because I've been very openly gay and well known, I've toured your country many times as a dyke comic and singer. I've been all over the world, and it is a common thread story, the latter part of the 20th century, amongst all of us in our community, the community of queers that we have, that has happened. Mm-hmm. And I think it's one of the things that draws us together, that sort of adversity in our past and how we were able to just stand up and say no more. I hope that happens with what's happening right now with women, us standing up and say no more. That was the beginning of change here in Australia. So hopefully that will happen for us with women as well in the world.